Love from love, hope from hope, and peace from peace. Here's a good story time. It's called Who Can Stand, from my book. And my book is thousands of pages long. That's why I'm able to have 500 videos in only a couple months. I'm simply reading from my materials. So,
story time for good stuff. Yay! It's time to everybody sing. Yay, let's sing a good song. Who can stand in the face of love?
you got to be as a little kid. So get ready, buckle up, please subscribe, and enjoy this reading.
And everybody says yay. Lots of applause.
Welcome, beloved. Adon Adonai's victorious voice of love is now booming louder than ever before. And he cries as the Lion of Zion from Jerusalem. And his voice is thundering all over Earth's circle, while drowning out the terrible screams of agony coming from under Satan's former bloodiest throne. Accursed therein is his machine of war, since that weapon will stop prospering of demonic spirits, will stop prospering as all things of darkness discover that their days are doomed. For Lucifer's beastly number of 666 is now reserved for every apostate, faithless, loveless soul not taking the curse of Malachi deathly serious, days as Noah, for it all has always been literal. For those not making an intelligent decision about that, it's the most insane decision that could ever be made, as God's Spirit says this, and the Lord speaks boldly in love, but to wake us up, for these are the days of the great restoration, the restitution, and the great refreshing. So the Lord says, when the senses are shaken, and that's exactly what he plans on doing in this hour, is shake our senses. Days burning as an oven, when the arrogant and the proud will not be left with neither root or branch. So he says, when the senses are shaken and the souls are driven to madness, who can stand? When everyone is convinced of his dove of love's legitimate prophecy, of the Lord's Bible codes ending all religion as it been known, because it proclaims that man is about to die, who will stand? And of the fools who don't act with those of faith's knowingness, who could stand as they roll over like disobedient dogs playing dead? Who can stand, people? And when those days start burning as a oven under man's sizzling emotions, because our whole race is about to die, who will stand? And when the souls of the oppressed fight in the troubled air that rages, who can stand? Or when the whirlwind of fury comes from the great white throne of God, from his great white cloud of Matthew 24 and Revelation 14, as it comes forth in this hour with his everlasting gospel, who can stand? For he is the sower of the seeds of love, and who can stand that? Everybody can, because he rises in love. And when the frowns of his countenance drives the nations together, who can stand without enlightenment, people? Who can stand? And that is the question of the hour. For it is foretold in Matthew 24, who shall feed the Lord's people while the Master is away? Who shall give them meat? Who can stand in the face of that materializing? Who? So we have to start asking ourselves the question. And so who will be brave enough to leave all places of God's worship that's condemning their brother and refuses to lift up his unconditional love unconditionally over all mankind, so that mankind can finally get along? If people are opposed to his kingdom age covenant, who can stand in the light of the refusal? For they make themselves into outwardly showing themselves to be Antichrist and standing against the kingdom age love and peace that comes. And who can stand in the face of dividing congregations all over the earth? The wheat and the tares can never grow together in light of this happening. So the judgment really does begin in the house of God. Who can stand before that? And who can stand when sin claps his broad wings over the battle and sails rejoicingly into a great flood of death? And who can stand during times of great deceit when naive souls are damned by their own lack of love and their love light out, the unforgivable sin? Who can stand? And thereby, who would be tossed into everlasting fires of perishing? Only those committing the unforgivable sin. And who cannot stand up and clap over that all religion is proven to be of no importance, for his love has transcended all doctrines. Our faith and our doctrines and our belief are as filthy rags before his perfect love, which is come. And he says to all mankind, Jeremiah 32:27 proclaims it. He says, I shall forgive your iniquity, and I shall remember it no more. If he did remember it, he would be a liar. So he says to all people of love, he says, I shall be your God, and you shall be my people. So when and that means he's got our back, people. And when the fiends of hell rejoice upon the slain, who can stand? Who has caused this? And who can answer at my throne? Asks Christ. And he says, I will therefore send my messenger of my last covenant, who will prepare the way before me with my own word, self-interpreting itself with no unlawful addition. And only my word alone shall prepare my own way, declares our absolute truth, that no one living in 2021 even believes that that my word of earth's curse in the prophets, in Isaiah 24, Zephaniah 1:1, Deuteronomy 18:18, and Malachi 4:6, and his word in Matthew 24:22, that unless the days of grace were cut short by this message of the kingdom age, that no flesh could be saved. So who can stand when Daniel comes forth as my third Elijah? The first is yet to come, people. The first would be the two witnesses, the original Elijah and the original Moses. But that future is the erasable curse of Malachi, says the spirit of prophecy. And it shall not come if people go to embrace their future of the kingdom age arising in peace and love, with the words of Isaiah 2, proving that in the latter days, no matter what translation it is looked at, in the latter days that man shall beat their swords of the spirit of the Bible and turn them into sickles of the spirit of love, the restoration of Acts 3:21, days of great refreshing, the restoration is upon us. So who can stand as Daniel comes forth with all of heaven's authority, asks the Lord? And who will believe my truth that the spirit of Moses rests upon him? Just watch my first video under this channel. It's called The Manifested Everlasting Gospel of Revelation 14. For the Lord says, by me and by his providence and by his wisdom, that I alone shall be able to accomplish through the Lord, sending out earth's salvation through his weeping spirit of love. For there is nothing that needs to be done for people to inherit the promise, the climax of all of the Bible, if only they would open their hands and receive it. So who mourns the lost souls who can be found only if they would start loving? Who can stand? And so for that reason, our Lord says, it's now the wondrous time of my fulfillment of Jeremiah 31 and 32. For the day of my Son of Love now arises after the gross darkness flees away at that Lion of Zion's softest roar. Moreover, the day of celebration is at hand, for I am Jehovah Nissi, the banner of love over all men, bar none whatsoever, since my love has gone before me and over all men. And absolutely no, there are no conditions upon anyone of love about morality, just to keep their love light on. For all who love are born of God and know God, because God is love. So who can stand? For this is the fullness of the law of Moses, and those walking in such love are assured of the Lamb's everlasting life. For they will never be condemned by him, no matter what, or else he would arise as a liar with guile in his mouth. So behold, the Lord says, my chosen Israel now has a brand new kingdom age covenant and a brand new ark for survival that is written within the words of this holy video, which has finally come forth exactly as foretold in King James Habakkuk 2, 1 through 6. In the end it has come and it has not lied. Behold, he whose soul might be not upright, but the just shall live by my faith. Even though I have been transgressed by wine, I am the alcoholic, Latter-day Daniel of Daniel 12:13, who causes the total shattering of the power of holy people, verse 7, by the gross darkness of Isaiah 60, being shattered by our Messiah of forgiveness, Christ arising as Isa Yeshua Jesus, who shall put all of his law of love in all hearts. Who can stand that, people? Who can stand? So it's time to stand up for love, for he comes on a cloud of his most remarkable magnificence. Receive his beneficence now.